Hey guys, so we are at episode 6 of the Art Hour series. Firstly, I'd like to wish all of you a very, very happy Diwali. Yes guys, it's been a while since my last episode and I thought that I should stop sitting around and recording my Art Hour series and I should do a little moving around so that you all would get a little more interesting people involved in this. So firstly, a very, very happy Diwali, and what I'd like to say today is that instead of just burning sparklers and, you know, celebrating Diwali and burning lights, switching the lights on outside, let's switch the light on inside. And that can be done simply by thought. I'm sure you've heard this before in my earlier episodes, but if you can think it, the universe can deliver it to you fully. It has the ability to deliver anything and everything that you have ever wanted. Look at the universe like a master kitchen that has every ingredient that you can ever imagine. So, as simply as when you think of a lime, you know, limbu, and you just keep on thinking of limbu and chaat masala constantly in your mind, you'll suddenly start salivating, you know, you'll start getting the saliva in your mouth with imagining the taste of the limbu. So similarly, if you could actually feel the situation that you want to be in as easily as you can imagine the limbu juice in your mouth when you're squeezing the lime in your mouth, the taste that you're getting will actually make you do that, right? So if you could actually start feeling how you would feel in the situation that you want to be. Suppose if this situation is, say you have a health issue that you're suffering from and you go through a lot of pain in a particular situation. So you imagine the situation where you're pain-free and what you're feeling in that pain-free situation. What would you do? What is the happiness that you would feel? Would you celebrate if you got out of this situation? If you were healed, who would the first person be? Who would you speak to? And what are the activities you would do if you were healed from this situation? So if you were to actually feel the joy of that healed situation, you are able to attract that situation into your life. And that is the law of attraction, because you magnetize what you focus your attention on. If you remember, as kids, you know, we would take this little paper and put a magnifying glass on it and then wait for the sun rays to go through that magnifying glass, magnify the heat of the sun, and actually that paper would burn if held in that, you know, same position for a very long time. So what was happening was that the focus of the heat and the light, the energy, was going through the magnifying glass and focusing on that little point on the paper, and when it was crossing a certain amount of time, whoosh, it was burning. Same way, if you were to hold your thoughts really, really strongly in your head for about 17 seconds, that would start attracting a vibration, an energy that is set out into the universe. And that universe would respond to you by making things happen around you that would lead you to achieve what your final goal is. Now, 17 seconds is not all you need to hold your thought for. You can hold it up to 68 seconds. And if you could do this between 17 seconds to 68 seconds, you would give it the real power of being able to manifest. Just like the magnifying glass over the paper held in front of the sunlight would make the paper burn, the same way the thought held in your head for over 17 seconds up to 68 seconds, and of course if you can do it longer, even better, for days and months and, as you know, hours in the day and as much as you can, if you were to vibrate on that energy and that frequency of wanting that thing, you'd be able to achieve it. So instead of focusing on what you don't want, why don't we focus on what we want? Instead of complaining, like I know certain people who don't like being in Bombay or don't like being in India, and they're like, they keep cribbing about India. Arre, itni gandagi hai, arre, itna pollution hai, arre, humare politicians aise hai, arre, GST ho gaya, arre, ye ho gaya. I mean, why don't you start focusing on what's good in India? Arre, hamari ganga saaf ho rahi hai, you know, GST is good because da 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 da, okay, corruption is ending, okay, the Me Too movement is out, safai ho rahi hai, okay, there are many good things we can look at. And what you look at and what you put your attention to is what is going to get magnified. So look at the better things in your life and focus on what you want rather than focusing on what you don't want. So if it is, your staff is always late, people are always bunking, your taxes are really high, you're not getting your share where you deserve to get your share, your friends are not treating you right, focus on the other things. Focus on the people that love you. Your mom loves you the most, you're her favorite sibling. Your friends love hanging with you. You've got the best sense of humor. Focus on the things that you really like. You love traveling. You know most about different places, like the people that do not, you know, people might not know so much about the kind of places that you've traveled to. So focus on what makes you happy. Focus on what you want. So if it is that company that you want to establish, or it is the health that you want to achieve, or it is the soulmate of your dreams, or it is traveling to a destination that you want, keep focusing on that. And there are two ways to do these things. Going out of breath. But before the light goes out, let me finish this. There are two ways to do these things. One is by taking a book and writing it down. It's best if you just have one thing that you focus on that you want the most. Okay, like on priority, number one priority, I want this. You cannot have a confusion that you want this and this. Oh, you can't decide which one you want more. Actually, you want your mom's health also, but you really want that career opportunity. If that happens, you'll travel here. Oops. So, my little friend's following me. Hello. So, you can have priority 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10,000, 2,000 you can have, fine. But your priority number one, which will manifest first for you, needs to be razor sharp. And when I say razor sharp, it means that that is the one point thing that you want the most. And there's nothing that you want more than that. I mean, you could want things, but it won't be as much as you want that. So the best thing would be to write that down, okay? Write down the others right under it and keep focusing on it. Read it like 2-3 times a day. Repeat it to yourself. Keep it within you, inside you. And read it about 2-3 times a day, as many times as you can. If you have more time to read it, more than 2-3 times, please read it more than that. But keep it a secret. Don't reveal it to anybody. Keep it all to yourself. And I promise you, it will manifest. Well, the other way to look at it is that some people, like me, don't like keeping things to myself. Not anymore. There used to be times I used to keep secrets and, you know, I'd like to believe that if I talk about it, it will not manifest. And, you know, I will wait till it happens and then I will talk about it. Bobby, you know, it works. It's fine. But I've come to believe slowly that I come under the category of people who now loves talking about what I want. So as much as I talk about it, as much as I focus my energy on it, as much as I tell people about what I want, the easily and faster it manifests. So if it is, like now I'm in Darjeeling, okay? I'm here on a holiday and I've been wanting to travel for a long time and it was just not happening. You know, it would be like something or another would come up. There would be an event or somebody's birthday or a shoot. I was just not able to take out, imagine, 4 nights to get on a holiday. And I wanted it to be a meditational weekend where I could write about my Artao series. So I said, okay, let me start manifesting. So I actually started telling everybody I met, oh, you know, I'm going for a holiday and I'm going to write about Artao and I'm going to meditate and I'm going to carry one nice dress to, you know, do one of the episodes. And everybody would be like, oh, okay, go. They wonder why I'm talking about it. It doesn't matter to anybody, right? But I believe that the more energy that I put into it, the faster it manifested. And then I didn't even know where I wanted to go. So I just closed my eyes, put my finger on the map of India, and I was like, this is where I want to go. I opened my eyes and it was Darjeeling. Like, okay, that's my destination. So I'm here and I'm recording Artao. So you can adapt to any two of the ways to use the law of attraction. One is by writing it down, being very sure about your priority number one, and then writing your 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Reading it thrice a day, not talking about it to anybody, but remembering it again and again and being razor sharp about what you really want. Because when you do that, when you keep reading it, when you keep remembering it, when you keep writing it, you are adjusting your vibration to the vibration of the universe to attract just that. So instead of focusing on what you don't want, start focusing on exactly what you want. And the second way of the law of attraction is by focusing all your energy on it, talking about it as much as you want, writing about it as much as you want, defining it, describing it, and actually feeling as if it's already happened. And the moment you start feeling that you've already achieved it and you start, you know, expressing gratitude for that situation that has not yet manifested, it will manifest. So guys, that's it for now. Happy Diwali again. Love you all. Lots of love and lots of light. Ciao. This is me signing off. Leave your comments below. Love you.